Hello, I'm Leonardo and welcome to my watchlist. Today I will review one of the most hyped releases of 2020, the 2-door Black Bay 58 in navy blue. And I will also tell you why I decided to sell it after 6 months of ownership. I think the brand Tudor is in no need for big introduction, especially after they returned into commercial mainstream by releasing the Black Bay line in 2013. Offering an affordable and most importantly available alternative to the Rolex Submariner with a strong connection to heritage models from Rolex and Tudor. The Black Bay 58 navy blue with the reference M79030B is one of the more recent additions to the Black Bay line and was released in July 2020. Currently, the steel Black Bay 58 is also available in black with rose gold accents. The price tag is €3,430 on the steel bracelet. I purchased the watch in October, so by now I own it for about half a year. Let's check the dimensions first. The case diameter is 39mm. I measure 47.6mm lug to lug. The watch is 11.9mm thick. Lug width is 20mm and the bracelet tapers down to 15.8mm at the clasp. The case and bracelet are made out of 316L stainless steel. The sapphire crystal is domed and equipped with an anti-reflective coating. The Black Bay features an unidirectional dive timing bezel with an aluminium inlay and one of the most satisfying 60 clicks I've ever experienced on a diver so far. The watch is water resistant up to 200m and has a screw down crown and screw down case back. Inside beats the in-house automatic caliber MT5402, which is COSC certified. The movement beats 28,800 times per hour and has a power reserve of 70 hours. As I already mentioned, the Black Bay 58 draws strong inspiration from past Tudor and Rolex dive watches. The Snowflake handset is known from the Tudor Submariner, released in 1968, which are supposed to provide good readability underwater. The style of the indices is also known from Tudor and Rolex Submariners. What did change is the combination of the Snowflake hands with the round indices. The original Tudor Submariners either had Snowflake hands and square indices or Mercedes hands with round and triangular indices. Personally, I feel like the new combination of several different shapes is not the perfect match. I would have preferred the original design, which they did reproduce on the Tudor Pelagos. The hands and indices are made out of white gold and are filled with white lume. In direct light, the satin dial has an almost pale blue tone with no visible texture, and you also notice that the aluminium insert is in a slightly darker navy blue. Continuing with the case, it's brushed on top and polished on the sides. The lugs have a very elegant side profile and I would say they are slightly longer than on other 39mm watches, but still well proportioned. Typical for Tudor watches, the case back is quite plain with some basic text, however the crown shows a detailed Tudor rose. The bracelet has a classic oyster style but with some differences to a Rolex oyster bracelet. The bracelet doesn't taper with a fluent edge. Each link has a fixed size, so the size jump from one link to another is visible. What's controversial about the bracelet are the fake rivets that serve no actual purpose. I would prefer the Tudor to have no rivets at all, but when wearing the watch, they are barely visible. The end links are solid and the links are connected by screws. The Tudor shield is resembled on the fold-over clasp, which is actually very inconvenient to open, at least on my particular model. It feels like I'm always very close to breaking my nails. The clasp is equipped with ceramic bearings, so it will close securely even after years in use, but unfortunately the clasp has no quick adjustment system and is only fitted with 3 micro adjustments. Now, why did I buy the Black Bay 58 and why do I want to sell it? When I first saw the blue Black Bay on pictures, I really liked the color in combination with the snowflake hands. The size is close to perfect for my wrist, and I can't deny I also like to have a watch from the Rolex family after I failed trying to get one from the AD. But after owning the watch, I can say that the Black Bay is missing some features that I want to have when I spend this amount of money on a watch. For a dive watch, it's a ceramic bezel and a quick adjustment system on the bracelet. Additionally, smaller problems like the clasp that's hard to open or the bezel insert that is not perfectly aligned further reduced my enjoyment when wearing the watch. Most of my dislikes of the Black Bay I should have definitely known before buying it, but I think the hype got to me even though I told myself it wouldn't. Did I sell the Black Bay because it's a bad watch? No, definitely not. In the end, it all comes down to personal preferences and if you enjoy wearing the watch. Me and the Black Bay, we just didn't match. Okay, that's it for the review. I hope you enjoyed it. What's your take on the Black Bay? Let me know in the comments. And if you enjoy the content, please like the video and subscribe to see more of my watch list.